So hello and welcome back to another Test Drive Thursday video. Today I am back on my laptop because my main computer is still not working. It's my first day after the exams are finished. I've spent the whole day trying to get it working. Guess what, it's still not working, so I don't know what's going to happen. But as I said, I'm back on my laptop. But here we have the DAF XF105 that I'm going to take a look at the configuration for today. So if we go into customize, I think there's only one cabin to choose from here. So yeah, you can either have it with the paint, or you can also have it with plastic like this, which personally I prefer the paint so much more. I just think it looks, I don't know, it just looks a lot much better than the plastic with those sort of blocky lines, which I really don't like. Like that, yeah, it's just, yeah, not very nice at all in my opinion. Yeah, so there's only two chassis. You've got with or without the painted or plastic grille, and then you've got, so yeah, that matches up with that. Or you can have a 6x2 four, where you can have with or without painted again. So with engines, there's 5 engines available, all the way from a 380 all the way up to a 520. So it's not really torquey, these engines, so range from a 1775 newton meters all the way up to 2500 newton meters. So yeah, not very torquey at all. There's 6 transmissions to choose from. You've got 12 speeds and some 6 speeds in there, all with or without retarder. And then if we go on to the interior, I really don't like this. I mean, you've got that, I just honestly, that light blue and then that plastic looking wood, it's just absolutely horrible. I mean, it sort of shows the truck's age, I suppose, but really, I don't know, it would just put me off driving this truck in this game, I think. I mean, the detail's really good, but the colour scheme is awful, pretty much, is no other way of saying it. Paint, you've got the standard ones and you can customise it. That blue's actually really nice on that metallic. But we'll just go for a white whilst we're looking at the customisation. Right then, so here we are. So if we start off down the bottom, you can add these mud guards, which are actually sort of showing their age, which you don't get very often in trucks in this game. It makes it look like the truck's used, which is really nice. You've got a Mirage low grill guard down there. You've got a number plate, then a Russia sort of symbol. Not too sure what this is, some kind of emblem of something. Not too sure. Right then, so up here we can have a multibar by Kelsa. So it doesn't look like you can customize that at all, it's just all standard stuff. Up here you can add some lights around the edge. Personally, I don't really like them, just the way they slightly stick out on the edge. If there were a few centimeters over, I don't think it would have been that bad, but they stick out quite a bit, which I don't like. Even with the paint, if you, yeah. So even with the paint, it looks worse. They just stick out more. So I don't like that. Let's take them off. So you can add some plates up here, all the ADR stuff, all that normal stuff. Lights around there, which again, just don't fit in the gaps. I mean, they stick out a bit, which is super annoying. But yeah. So well, that's at the back. We'll come back to that later. So we've got a number plate up there as well if you want it. That's at the back as well. Yeah, it's kind of annoying, you can't tell which dots are which. So you can add a, or you can change the length of the front mirror. With the main mirrors, look at that, you can add 3 mirrors. Hang on. Oh, only on the one side. Wow. It's a bit unusual. You don't have a single mirror as well. But yeah, look, it's not symmetrical. So the only way to have it symmetrical is to have double on both sides. But yeah, it's a bit unusual having 3. I never really see it very often. On the sun visors, you can have it colour or glass with or without that logo. We can have another company logo there. Some another bars. Oh, hang on, look at that. Sort of red box there. Something's not quite right. Another bar. I think that's in Seoul. Look at that, it's a bit weird. So that's inside as well, I'm guessing. I can't quite see. It's a bit annoying, this. I never get why they don't just separate them. Some more lights, horns, beacons, aircon unit, and then I'm guessing this at the back is wind deflectors. Yeah, cool. So okay, it's still there, that red thing. So let's go around to the back. I think there's no side skirts. You can't actually access the dots from the back, which is weird. I think that's a number plate. You have some chrome tread plates, and then onto the interior, I think. Oh no, yeah. So normal stuff really. Have a little carpet there. I think it would look better at all the seats black and like a blue highlight in that sort of colour. I think it'll just look a lot better. I know it might not be realistic, but I mean, it would look so much nicer than this. McDonald's coffee mug. That's a, what's that, blanket at the back. Usual stuff down here. What's that? Looks like some kind of bottle, water bottle or something. You've then got stuff on the dash, curtains, what's that, blind, oh that's nice. It's better than the SCS ones, which are, I'm trying to show you, like that, or, I mean, it's not showing, that's a lot better. And then what's that, radio, and then probably want a sat nav because there isn't a built in one. Change this deflector colours as well. But there we go, that's the configuration for this truck. If you enjoyed the video, please click like and want to subscribe for a lot more videos to come. And that's if my computer starts working, but hopefully it will. I'll try and keep fixing it, but I think it's broken. But again, thank you for watching and goodbye.